vehicle overall body weight is under pressure to be reduced as it influences fuel efficiency and thus driving range. Weight also plays a crucial role in the overall performance of the vehicle, but meeting multiple needs at the same time is not a given. How to make sure a vehicle has the required overall stiffness while also providing the right driving feel, and how to make sure that this does not negatively affect NVH performance? It's all a matter of finding balance, and to do this, both testing and simulation tools have become key. Simcenter allows to evaluate and balance different performance attributes within one platform. The process starts by measuring the system dynamics in the frequency range of interest. This requires the proper selection of shaker excitation locations and a good position of the accelerometers on the body. With Simcenter 3D structural dynamics, you can make use of a finite element model template. The analysis not only provides a test wireframe geometry with the sensor's location, but also a preview of the expected mode shapes. Next, the vehicle body needs to be instrumented, and the complete test setup will most likely consist of hundreds of channels. Simcenter provides a tablet-based instrumentation app that really helps during this process, with validation of the instrumentation setup and correction of potential instrumentation errors. To excite the body structure, Siemens provides a wide range of self-aligning Q-sources shakers that can be mounted directly on the relevant excitation locations. For trimmed car bodies, which have highly damped modes, it can be crucial to have many different locations at the same time to properly excite the full vehicle body. Once all data is acquired, model analysis can start. Within Simcenter Test Lab, a model is fit over the measured FRFs, in most cases using the well-established Polymax algorithm. The different modes are selected from the stabilization diagram, either manually or automatically. For highly damped and complex structures, such as trimmed bodies, more advanced algorithms such as MLMM are crucial. MLMM stands for Maximum Likelihood Modal Model, and iteratively improves modal model, while at the same time preparing for better correlation with the CAE model. The results are now ready for export to Simcenter 3D, where they can be used for comparison of numerical modes, as well as to update the CAE model. With this true digital twin, it now becomes possible to find the right balance between different performance attributes, as we set out to do.